Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Last Saturday, I announced the launch of the DAOYI website, a platform for the DAOYI organization. With my colleagues and students, we are working on this site and hopefully more and more functions will be added on a weekly basis. Since last week, I have received some emails from the community and many of those emails are very informative, constructive, and encouraging. I will definitely keep working on it. This week, I have been working on adding a social network function to this site. The plan is to use a popular social network as a platform for communication. There are two candidates at this moment. One is Facebook, since we can create a Facebook group and then add a link on our site. Another solution is use Discord, a more and more popular social network platform for the same function. I would like to choose one from those two candidates. Therefore, I would like to ask for opinions from the community about which platform you prefer. Please voice your opinion in the comment area or send me an email if you prefer to be anonymous. Again, our objective for this function is to provide a place for our community members from different countries. Over the decades, I have received many questions about Fa Li and Fa Jin, both on and off YouTube. The most recent one being from Don Man. Simply put, Fa Li is an action where the body releases force at high speed. You may have often heard people use the term explosive power when talking about Xing Yi. Well, explosive power is nothing but Fa Li. Fa Li is a very important topic, and since I have introduced some relevant topics related to Fa Li already, there's no time like the present to talk about Fa Li. There are some misperceptions in the community regarding Fa Li, especially in the last few years. That's why I will also talk about those issues in today's video to help you identify and avoid those misperceptions in the future. Starting today, I will add a new section in my videos named Common Misperceptions. I will use this section to clarify some common mistakes or misunderstandings rampant in the community. Recently, I have realized that clarification of a misperception is just as important as explaining the concept correctly. In Chinese, we call it 去伪存真，正本清源. Translation: eliminating the false and returning the true makes order out of confusion. I will keep using this proverb as my motto in working on this channel so that the community will not only get authentic information but also be able to avoid misinformation. Topics covered in today's video include: first, origin and history of Fa Li. Second, importance of Fa Li. Third, how to practice Fa Li. Fourth, common misperception about Fa Li. Fifth, principles of Fa Li. Sixth, demonstration. Seventh, correction of students' practice. And eighth, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. Origin and history of Fa Li. Fa Li, also called Fa Jin, consists of two characters. Fa means release, execute. Li means force or power. The other term Fa Jin expresses the same meaning. Jin means force and power, just another name of the character Li. So, Fa Li and Fa Jin are interchangeable. In that video, In order to avoid unnecessary confusion, I will only use the term Fa Li, but please keep in mind that both Fa Li and Fa Jin are the same. Like many terms used in Chinese martial arts, very often there are terms widely used without a clear definition. It's the same with Fa Li. You have to know that a practice such as Fa Li has been used in many martial arts, no matter if a definition exists or not. Fa Li is a force releasing and execution movement at high speed, which is a common practice and a skill required for many martial art. The difference is that to some styles, such as internal styles of martial art, for example, Xing Yi, focuses on its Fa Li training. As a result, Fa Li is a major part of the Xing Yi training, which sets Xing Yi apart from other styles. So, where did Fa Li come from? Based on my research, Fa Li as a concept was the first implied in Chang Shi Wu Ji Shu, or Book of Chang Family Martial Techniques, written by Chang Naizhou, a prominent martial artist who lived from 1724 to 1783. By the way, I have briefly introduced Chang Naizhou in one of my prior videos titled Internal Style Concept 30, Zhuan Guan. Link is in the description. Some martial artists, such as Li Zijian, believe that this book was written more than 400 years ago and Chang Naizhou was not the author but the editor and the publisher of this book. In this book, Chang Naizhou said, quote, 何事不嫌其小，欲气何得足也？开事不嫌其大，欲力发得出也。 Translation: When contracting, it does not matter if the posture becomes very compact, but the energy should be strong. When expanding, it does not matter if the posture becomes very big, since the force should be able to release and execute it outwards. So, the two characters Li and Fa are used to express the action of force release. Chang Naizhou's writing was in an old-fashioned or classical Chinese or Wen Yan Wen. So, Li here is the noun and Fa is the verb. It was written in a passive voice. However, if you want to express it in an active voice, it should be Fa Li, since Fa is the verb and Li is the noun. That's why sometime later, people have been using the term Fa Li, since Fa Li is in an active voice linguistically. Later, Wang Xiangzhai, the great martial artist and founder of Yi Quan, used the term Fa Li in many of his writings. So, Fa Li was first officially used by Wang Xiangzhai as a training procedure in his teaching instead of a mere concept in other styles. When I was a child, this term was mostly used in the Xing Yi community compared to other styles since Xing Yi practice really emphasized Fa Li training, which makes Xing Yi very unique in terms of power release and execution. I have to say that without Fa Li, Xing Yi will no longer be considered Xing Yi, but the same won't be true for other styles. For example, Tai Chi will still be considered Tai Chi with or without Fa Li. So, for the last few decades, all of the Xing Yi practitioners really focuses on not only the term Fa Li, but more importantly, the training method of the style. I have mentioned in a prior video that back when I was a child, in Tianjin, whenever Xing Yi practitioners met each other, they would very often demonstrate their Fa Li practice in front of the others in order to illustrate their training effect. I met the Xing Yi master in his 70s who had recovered from a stroke, and I was also told that he recovered by practicing Xing Yi. He always demonstrated his powerful Fa Li to his students. I remember like it was yesterday. Disclaimer, what I mentioned just now was only the experience of one Xing Yi master. It was not medical advice and should not be interpreted as such. You should first consult a doctor if you have any cardiac issues and you are interested in practicing any martial art. So, please do not misunderstand me. Now, back to the topic of Fa Li history. About 30 years ago, Fa Li became widely popular in the community, and since then, almost every style started using the term Fa Li to describe their martial performance. Because Fa Li is an important fourth training method with great martial effect, which reflects the spirit of martial art practice, it is no wonder that Fa Li became more and more popular. However, simply using a term without specific well-crafted training method will only take a style so far. The presence and focus on Fa Li training and effects, and not just the concept, is precisely what gave Xing Yi its reputation. So, what is Fa Li? I define Fa Li as a strong force released in a small movement at a high speed in order to amplify its martial effect. Good Fa Li involved three factors. First, body structure, which is the foundation of a strong force. Second, speed. And third, short distance. Without any of these three, it would not be considered Fa Li. A stance can be strong, but if there is no speed, then it would not be considered Fa Li. If the speed is very high, but the movement is very big, or the trail of the force release is long, then it would not be considered Fa Li either. Only strong force released at a high speed in a short distance is considered Fa Li. I created this definition based on my practice and teaching experience, in addition to consulting many other martial artists in China. Topic 2. Importance of Fa Li. Just like I mentioned in the prior sections that even though all Chinese martial art styles have force releasing movements, that Fa Li result and effect would very often greatly depend on luck unless you proactively practice Fa Li. However, if the expected result offered by a style is based on luck without a well-defined Fa Li training component, it is not considered a Fa Li-based style. This is why many Chinese martial artists regard Xing Yi as a Fa Li-based style since its training system is based on Fa Li. So, for about a century already, the first impression of Xing Yi is its martial effectiveness due to its Fa Li training created by the founder and the masters in different generations, before, now, and I really hope even in the future. Some other styles, such as Chen style Tai Chi, especially the second routine of Chen style, the Cannon Fist, is also very famous for its Fa Li effect. By the way, when Chen style was first introduced to Beijing, many people initially refused to recognize it as Tai Chi since people were used to perceiving Tai Chi based on Yang style and other branches that used slow motions practice. Actually, based on my knowledge and research, all of the Tai Chi styles have a Fa Li training exercise, but they were not taught in public. So sometimes, martial art styles were not created equally and fairly. Fa Li is a common practice in Xinyi, but it's commonly considered as indoor practice to most Tai Chi schools in the old days. In order to emphasize the importance of Fa Li, Xinyi, especially from the second generation, such as Gu Yunsheng, started emphasizing Fa Li in terms of levels such as Ming Jin, An Jin, and Hua Jin, or obvious force, hidden force, and neutralizing force. Those forces are named under the term of obvious, hidden, and neutralizing because of the characteristics of their execution. But the core of Fa Li is still the same: short distance, high speed, and powerful effect. Furthermore, regarding the effect, if someone used a soft movement but claims it to be a hidden force, that is just wrong. Hidden force is still a force, not a soft boiled noodle. Fa Li is widely used in Chinese martial arts, especially in the internal styles. But based on my observations, any Chinese style can integrate Fa Li into their training system to amplify its martial effectiveness. Any style, no matter how well developed, always has room for further improvement. Again, Fa Li training needs three criteria: short distance, strong force, and high speed. To summarize, Fa Li is a very important aspect to a Chinese martial art. No matter what style, adding Fa Li elements can make your practice progress faster. Topic 3. How to practice Fa Li. As mentioned in the previous section, Fa Li has to be proactively practiced so that it can be integrated into your martial movements. The objective of Fa Li training is to maximize the power generation so that the martial effect will be greatly improved in a combat situation. Therefore, any exercise that can help to achieve this objective should be analyzed and applied in Fa Li training. Since Xinyi is a style that is naturally suited to achieve expected Fa Li results, I will use Xinyi as an example in this video to explain the Fa Li training method. In Fa Li training, I'd like to emphasize three elements. First, identify the most important muscle groups. Second, choose the right body structure, especially a standing posture that is most suitable to Fa Li. Third, maintain a relaxed yet alert mental state. Let me explain them one by one. First, muscle groups. Changing the state of the muscles is the source of force. As a martial artist, being able to identify the right muscle groups used in any specific power generation is the first step. Different body movements involve different muscle groups, and not all of the muscle groups can generate the same force due to the limits and constraints of our physical structure. Basically, two muscle groups are generally focused on in practice. They are the muscles around the hips and the muscle from the lower back to the upper back. I prefer to add another group, which is the muscle connecting the chest to the shoulder. Like I mentioned in some prior videos, Xinyi practice traditionally requires more practice for three body types in order to compensate for limitations caused by one's body structure. They are very long but not that strong legs, weak lower back area, and thin chest. Traditionally, people visually called those three weak areas as Tang Lang Tui, Shui She Yao, Pian Bang Zi, or Mantis Leg, Snake Waist, and Sheet Chest. Actually, Those three expressions are just used to describe an insufficient practice of those three key body areas for Fa Li. In the old days, well-experienced Xingyi teachers could identify a student's physical weakness and add more specific training method in that area. So, if you think those three body parts are not that strong, I highly recommend focusing on training them. Traditionally, we believe that different muscles built by different type of training play different roles in Fa Li. As I have already mentioned in the past, I'm not opposed to weightlifting. As long as the muscle developed does not end up compromising your striking speed, it's all good. In addition to strength training, you should also focus on speed training. Very often, muscles strengthened by weightlifting alone may not help your speed. Muscle development is very important, but we need to strike a balance between strength and speed. Second, body posture and stance. If you observe stance practice among different Chinese styles of martial arts, you will notice Xingyi is particularly greatly emphasizes a back-weighted stance, which means most often a majority of your weight is supported by your back leg. Some styles like Bagua use a similar approach, even though Bagua stepping or stance is not exactly the same as the Xingyi stance. Based on my personal experience, this kind of back-weighted stance is the most suitable for Fa Li execution. Some people say that the Xingyi stance is designed with defense as the primary objective. Well, that is not true. Xingyi is an aggressive style compared to many other Chinese styles. The reason for the back-weighted stance is to improve the flexibility of the hip and the waist area to facilitate Fa Li. So, Fa Li in internal style practice, especially in Xingyi, is directly related to the standing posture. Also, the Shenfa or body method in Xingyi is designed for Fa Li as well. I will elaborate on Shenfa in the future. Third, mental state. For effective Fa Li, you need to relax not only the body but also the mind. This will enable your entire body to act in unison and maximize the martial effect. However, a relaxed mind does not mean a careless mind. Relaxation should be accompanied by alertness. In fact, with sufficient practice, you will realize that relaxation will actually elevate your mental alertness. I always tell my students that the real indicator of a good Fa Li is that you can release the force when the mind is in a relaxed state. Again, physical relaxation without mental relaxation will only be considered partially relaxation. Alertness is for quick reaction, while a relaxed state is for releasing the force in a smooth manner. It is an advanced topic, and I will definitely talk about it more in the future. In summary, to practice Fa Li, you have to pay special attention to these three aspects. First, identifying the important muscle groups. Second, proper standing posture. And three, mental state. Topic 4. Common misperceptions about Fa Li. A commonly noticed phenomenon in many arts is that as the external environment changes with time, the perception of the art along with its training method also change. Well, this can be a mixed bag with both good and bad effects. An undoubtedly unfortunate result is the emergence of misperceptions. Some very common concepts and practice can be easily misinterpreted or misrepresented due to changes in situations over time. Fali is no exception to this phenomenon. There are some common misperceptions regarding Fali that are worth of our attention so that you can identify and avoid them going forward. First, some people deny the existence of Fali. They claim that if you read some classical martial art documents, Fali as a term did not exist 50 years ago. I heard this claim a few years ago when somebody talked about Fali exercise. Well, it is totally wrong. Think about it. Fali as a term has not only existed for more than 50 years, but it is also the core practice of Xing Yi. No matter what, if Fali is the core practice of a style, any apparent lack of existence of Fali on paper is no way implies the lack of its practical existence. If it's not documented, then it only proves a lack of documentation. It does not prove the non-existence of Fali. Second, some people claim that since Xing Yi practice requires each movement to be powerful or that Fali should be present in every movement, then there's no need to talk about Fali. In other words, anyone who talks about Fali is wrong. Well, this claim couldn't be further from the truth. Yes, Fali should be everywhere in Xing Yi practice. However, it does not mean that we should not conceptualize the term of Fali. Being able to conceptualize a practice is an indicator of the well-development of the style. Both logically and technically speaking, this claim is just wrong. Long story short, do not confuse Fali with Fight Club. In other words, every practitioner should understand, talking about, and focus on Fali. Third, some people claim that in Fali, the body should not make any sound. Well, that is another totally mistaken claim. Body sound is just a result. Yes, in Fali, very often there is a body sound accompanying the force release because any high-speed movement combined with sudden changes of physical state of the body parts will generate a sound. It is a normal and natural phenomenon. If you cannot even generate body sound in Fali practice, it only means that your practice is still at a very low level. At a high level of Fali practice, there must be a body sound. Only burglars are afraid of making body sounds, and it's not something a martial artist should do. Fourth, some people claim that Fali practice will deplete energy. Well, that is just an over-concern about Fali. Yes, any physical movements consume energy, including sleeping and breathing. However, it is not an excuse to not practice Fali since martial art practice definitely and unavoidably consumes more energy than many other activities. However, we can replenish our energy with a good diet, rest, and so on. So, please do not worry about it at all. Your practice will only improve after you consume your energy in martial practice. Martial artists can practice meditation, but martial art practice is not meditation. Those were just four of the most common misperceptions. Of course, there are many others. With these four examples, you can see that some claims may seem reasonable at first glance, but they have no basis in reality. They are just false claims. topic 5, principles of Fa Li. Now, I'd like to talk about 3 principles of Fa Li. Since Fa Li is not that widely researched in China, even though many practitioners talk about it on a daily basis, I'd like to introduce 3 important principles that I created based on my practice and teaching experience over decades. First, Li Chu Xing Bu Bian. Translation: release force without compromising structure. Li means force, Chu means released, executed, Xing means form, body, structure, Bu means without, Bian means changed or compromised. Together, it means even though Fa Li is an intensive body action, but at the end of the Fa Li action, the body structure is still correct. Very often, without a high level of physical control, practitioners' body structure may not be in a good situation, since force-releasing movements at a high speed does change the body structure. A situation to prevent it from happening is to improve your own control over your body, especially make sure that your mind can control your body motion. Of course, easier said than done. During a very high-speed force-releasing motion, the mind may often lose control over the body. So, Li Chu Xing Bu Bian, or the ability to maintain the correct body structure both during and after Fa Li, is an objective of practice. Second, Fa Li Tong Tou Shi Ru Yong Quan. Translation: release force through penetrating movements like a bursting spring without blockage. Fa means releasing, Li means force, Tong means throw, Tou means penetrating, Shi means movement, Ru means like, Yong means bursting, Quan means spring. Put together, it means that during the Fa Li process, the power released is like a bursting spring without blockage. So, at an advanced level of Fa Jin, the force should be released like the movement of a released spring without any blockage. Any pausing and hesitation is a sign of a blockage. One can fake up their movements at a normal speed, but all of the mistakes will manifest in high-speed movements. The reason is very simple. The mind should be able to guide the body, and the body should be able to coordinate with the mind so that the body correctly moves like the bursting spring. So, maintaining a calm mental state and alternating between intense and relaxed focus is the key for Fa Li practice. Figurative expressions can help the audience visualize the correct practice in a more comprehensive way. This is why I use the bursting spring expression to describe correct Fa Li practice. Third, 视之如猫, 触之如虎. Translation: looks like a cat, feels like a tiger. 视 means look at, 知 means it, 如 means like, 猫 means cat, 触 means touch. 知 means it, 视 means is, 虎 means tiger. Put together, it means it looks like a cat, but when you touch it, it is a tiger. I use this term to describe the effect of the Fa Li on the opponent. Very often, a Fa Li movement looks very gentle for the most part because Fa Li is a sudden force, a force released at high speed at a very short distance. However, during the Fa Li, the recipient can feel the strong power injected to the body. I have to say that you have to experience it so that you will know how great the impact is on the recipient's body after receiving this kind of force release. So, if you are a cat, then you have to become a tiger through practice. Limiting yourself to soft movements without any fatigue practice will definitely keep you a cat forever. Of course, there are many more relevant principles that I will talk about in future, but for now, these three principles will guide you well in your fatigue practice. Topic 6, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a Xingyi fatigue exercise from Zhang Zhaodong's Xingyi branch. It is a single leg stance fatigue exercise. Hello, I'd like to demonstrate one of the Zhang Zhaodong's Fajin exercise. So this single leg exercise. So 1, 2, again. So 1, 2, again. So again. Turn another angle. So 1, 2. Topic 7. Correction of a student's practice. I'd like to correct my students' fatigue exercise. It is from the Li Cunyi's branch Xingyi. The name is Shuang Ma Xing or Double Horse Punch. I'm not letting my students demonstrate Li Cunyi's Double Horse Punching exercise. And then I correct his movement. Okay, you can face to there first. Okay. Then, okay, very good. Change the face to here so that you can see this angle. Okay. First of all, if you face to here, you just face to here, yes. First of all, the distance between the feet open a little bit more to here, yes. Continue. Second, when you push, right, use the force from the bike. From the bike. No. Here, open more. Like this. Horse punch me, right? So like this kind of movement. So use here to strike. No, from the back. Continue. And the last moment, the force from the knee pull forward. Yes, the kind of vibration. You need the kind of vibration. Yes, continue. Then here extend outward. Elbow extend outward, then punch. Then focus on, don't look at me, focus on one place. Then here, push out last second. Yes. Yes, very good. Topic 8, takeaways. First, my definition of a fatigue. A strong force released in a small movement at a high speed in order to amplify its martial effect. Second, origin and history of fatigue. Fatigue was first implied in a book of Chang family martial techniques written by Chang Naizhou and first widely used by Wang Xiangzhai, the founder of Yiquan, in his writings. Third, importance of fatigue. Fatigue is a very important aspect to a martial artist. No matter what style, adding some fatigue elements can make your practice progress faster. Of all the styles, Xingyi by design focuses on fatigue. Other styles can and often do integrate fatigue in their practice. For example, the second routine of the Chen style Tai Chi focuses on fatigue. Fourth, how to practice fatigue. To practice fatigue, you have to pay special attention to these three aspects. First, identifying the important muscle groups. Second, proper standing posture. And the third, mental state. Fifth, common misperceptions of fatigue. First, denial of fatigue because it's not mentioned in classical documents. Second, do not talk about fatigue because fatigue is everywhere in Xingyi. Third, fatigue should not make any sound. And fourth, fatigue practice depletes energy. Sixth, principles of fatigue. First, Li Chu Xing Bu Bian. Translation, release force without compromising structure. Second, fatigue Tong Tou, 势如泉涌。Translation: Release force through penetrating movements like a bursting spring without blockage. Third: 视之如猫，触之如虎。Translation: Looks like a cat, feels like a tiger. Seventh: Make sure to check out the demonstration and the student correction section to get concrete examples of exercises to include in your own Fali practice.So, that brings us to the end of today's video. Thank you for watching. See you next time and enjoy Fali practice.